Hello dear students, welcome back to my online classes. In the previous sessions, we have seen that how the author as a boy had developed aversion to water and how the misadventure at YMCA pool created a deep impact in the heart and mind of the author. So this misadventure had created a deep space for the terror, and its impact can be seen in his further life. So now in today's session we will see how the author made attempts to overcome his fear and how he finally succeed in his dreams. A few years later, when I come to know the water of the cascades, I wanted to get into them. Cascades means waterfall. But the author has a great liking for water games. So whenever he heard about the cascades, the falling waterfall, then he always was fascinated and attracted towards it and wanted to enjoy playing with it. And whenever I did, whether I was wading the Titan or bumping river or bathing in lake of the god rocks, the terror that had seized me in the pool would come back. But whenever even the thought of enjoying in the water comes in the heart and mind of the child, that terror begins to dominate his mind. And as soon as he just imagined to play in the Titan or the bumping river or taking bath in the water lake or the god rocks, that terror used to dominate his body and mind. That impact of misadventure always try to dominate his body. It would take possession of me completely. My legs would become paralyzed. Icy horror would grip my heart. And whenever I imagine to play, whenever I imagine to go to any water source, that terror always take hold of me, and I was completely in terror, and his legs and his body becomes paralyzed. This handicap stayed with me as the years rolled by, and this terror of being drowned continued for several years as the time passed, but this terror remains active in the heart of the author. In canoes on many lakes, fishing for landlocked salmon, bass fishing in New Hampshire, trout fishing on the Deschutes and Metolius in Oregon, fishing for salmon on the Columbia, at Bumping Lake in Cascades. Wherever I went, the haunting fear of the water followed me. So, many time, author accompanied his father, sometimes his friends, for fishing. Salmon is a kind of fish, so whenever he went for fishing with his friends in New Hampshire or in Deschutes and Metolius and even fishing in Columbia. So wherever the author has went, this fear always accompany him. So he never enjoyed playing or fishing with his friends. I ruined my fishing trips, deprived me of the joy of canoeing, boating and swimming. And thus The author realized that he had ruined his fishing trips. He was completely deprived of the joy of water games like canoeing, boating, and swimming. I used every way I knew to overcome this fear, but it held me firmly in its grip. So every time, many times, the author tried to overcome this fear because he wanted to enjoy water games. But whenever he made any attempt, that terror always seized him. Finally, one day, one October, I decided to get an instructor and learn to swim. Then finally, the author decided that he will hire an instructor and he will learn swimming. I went to a pool and practiced 5 days a week, an hour each. The instructor put a belt around me. A rope attached to the belt went through a pulley that ran on an overhead cable. Then again the author joined a swimming pool where he practiced 5 days a week for 1 hour. So then an instructor had made some arrangement where the author's body was attached to a rope through a cable, and he held on to the end of the rope, and we went back and forth across the pool, hour after hour, day after day, week after week. On each trip across the pool, a bit of the panic seized me. Each time, the instructor relaxed his hold on the rope and went under. Some of the old terror returned and my legs froze. So he started his learning with the help of the cable attached to his body. But whenever the instructor hold loose the rope and the boy seemed to be drowned, so again a strange terror tried to seize his body, and all his legs and hands seems to be paralyzed. It was 3 months before the tension began to slack. So continuous training for 3 months had somewhat reduced his terror. Then he taught me to put my face underwater and exhale, and to raise my nose and inhale. I repeated the exercise 100 times, bit by bit. I said part of the panic that seized me when my head went underwater. So when the author realized that intensity of the terror has got reduced after a training of 3 months, then the instructor taught him to exhale under the water and how to inhale by raising head out of the water. And again he practiced, repeated different exercises hundreds of times, and slowly that panic he was getting out of that terror. Next he held me at the side of the pool and had me kick with my legs. For weeks I did just that. At first my legs refused to walk, but they gradually relaxed and finally I could command them. So when the author learned to inhale and exhale, how to exhale underwater and how to inhale out of the water, then his instructor taught him to kick with his legs, how he can move his body forward through the water body. So but at the beginning his legs refused to work, but slowly with continuous practice he could command his legs, and he started kicking with his legs. Thus piece by piece he built a swimmer, and then when he had perfected each piece, he put them together into an integrated whole. In April, he said, "Now you can swim, dive off and swim the length of the pool, crawls, stroke. So piece by piece, by teaching different part of the swimming, the instructor made the author as a good swimmer, and then he perfected each part of his swimming, and then he asked him to integrate all different parts of swimming, and finally in the month of April, the instructor told that now you can swim. And he instructed the author to dive into the pool and swim along the length of the pool by himself. I did. The instructor was finished. So the author followed the instructions of his instructor, and then as the author swam across the pool without any fear, so the instructor announced that now his training is over. Now he has learned swimming, he is a good swimmer, now his training is over. But I was not finished. I still wondered if I would be terror stricken when I was alone in the pool. I tried it. I swam the length up and down. Tiny vestiges of the old terror would return, but now I could frown and say to that terror, trying to scare me, oh well, here to you, look, and off I would go for another length of the pool. But after the training is over, the author realized that he is not still prepared for swimming. So he decided to swim the pool alone in absence of his tutor, and then he realized that in few moments the terror would try to seize his body, but now the author was much confident because now he knew how to swim. So he challenged the terror and swam again the length of the pool. This went on until July, but I was still not satisfied. So the author swam the pool lonely for the next 2 months. But he was not satisfied. Still, he had a doubt in his mind. I was not sure that all the terror had left. So I went to Lake Wentworth in New Hampshire, dived off a dock at Trix Island, and swam 2 miles across the lake to Stamp Act Island. Then, as the author was not sure that terror had left him completely, so too, experience is terror, he went to Lake Wentworth in New Hampshire, where he dived off from a dock at Trick Island and swam 2 miles across the lake to Stamp Act Island. So all alone he swam through the sea 2 miles away. I swam the crawl, the breaststroke, the side stroke, and the backstroke. So these are the different forms of swimming. So throughout this journey, he crawl, he practiced breaststroke, side stroke, and backstroke. Only once did the terror return when I was in the middle of the lake. I put my face under and saw nothing but bottomless water. So during this 2 miles journey in the sea, while swimming, the author felt terror. The moment when he tried to see under the water and he could see the depth of the sea. So at that time he felt a little terror, but then again he regained his confidence. The old sensation returned in miniature. I laughed and said, "Well, Mr. Terror, what do you think you can do to me?" I fled and swam on. So this old sensation returns in miniatures, means very minutely, but again the author was much confident and he challenged again the terror and said that, well, Mr. Terror, what can you do of me? Now I am not scared of you. And again he started swimming and continued its swimming. Yet I had residual doubts. At first, my first opportunity, I hurried west, went up to the Titan to concrete meadows, up the concrete creek trails to Mid Glacier, and camped in the high meadows by the sides of Warm Lake. But still, the author had some doubts about the terror in his mind, so he took an opportunity and went to the west, to the Titan, to Concord Meadows, and up to the Concord Creek Trails, to Mid Glacier, and camped in the high meadows around the Warm Lake. So now the author has set out for camping in the high altitudes, in the mountains and meadows. The next morning I stripped, dived into the lake and swam across to the other shore and back, just as Doug Corprone used to do. And again early in the morning he took off his clothes quickly, dived into the lake and swam across the lake many times. And now he felt it very easy in swimming, and no terror seems to grieve him. I shouted with joy, and Gilbert Peak returned the echo. And now the author felt relaxed. Now he was 100% sure that he had conquered the terror. And so out of joy he shouted, and all the words shrieked by the author were returned in form of echo. I had conquered my fear of water. So the statement which he made was that he has made his conquest, he has made his victory over the fear of water. And these old words were again resounded in the valley through echo. The experience had a deep meaning for me, as only those who have known stark terror and conquered it can appreciate. But this experience of victory over my terror had a great meaning for me, and this victory, the true victory or the happiness of such victory, can be only appreciated by those who had conquered terror in their life. In death, there is peace. There is terror only in the fear of death. So the author acknowledged that there is peace in death, because after dying, people don't feel any sensation, but the terror lives in the fear of death itself. So people used to scared at the thought of being dead. But after death, everyone feels completely in peace. As Roosevelt knew when he said, all we have to fear is fear itself. It means there is no any cause for the fear. Only we have to fear is the fear itself. Means once if we are able to conquer the fear, then there is no need to fear. Because I had experienced both the sensation of dying and terror that fear of it can produce, the will to live somehow grew in intensity. Now at the end of this lesson, the author shared his experience that, and he said that, I have closely realized the sensation of death, as we have seen when he was just drowning in the YMCA poll. So very closely he has experienced the death sensation and also the terror that caused out of fear. So now the intensity to live had somewhat grew more strongly, and now the author wanted to live and live his further life very happily, wanted to enjoy his life up to its fullest. At last, I felt released, free to walk the trails and climb the peaks and to brush aside fear. And now the author was very much relaxed and free to walk along the trails, along the dense forests, along the peak, and there was no any feeling of terror. Now the author was able to conquer his terror. So thus we have seen that how through hard work, through perseverance, strong willpower, how the author was able to control his emotions and have achieved victory over his terror. So deep water, as the name of the lesson is, had a great impact in the life of the author itself. During his childhood, this deep water had created a terror in his mind, and as he grew up to during his adolescence, this terror of water gave him the challenge, created obstacles in his life, and again deep water itself has given him plenty of pleasure when he put all its effort to overcome him. So this is the end of the video, and for your assignment, explore link in the description box. Till then, take care, stay home, goodbye.
Stay home.